And the other thing that I saw was Nick Green, who pitched a few years back for Southern Maryland, actually picking up a kid and helping him run the bases after a game. Those are two moments that stand out in my mind, but Jackson and Halton today sort of added to those memories of watching ball players on the field with the small children. Tanner Peters getting the start for the Barnstormers here today. Peters, a right-hander from Simi Valley, California. He is 25 years of age. He goes 6 feet tall and weighs only 175 pounds. He has thrown well since coming to Lancaster. Rich Rundle's alluded to that on the dugout report today. 6 1/3 innings. He has allowed 6 hits, 2 runs. He has walked 2, and he has struck out 7. Peters will be backed up defensively by Josh Bell at third. The shortstop is Justin Jackson. Jeff Coburn is at second. Sean Halton is at first. Josh Whitaker will make the start in left field. Logan Schaefer in center. Caleb Gindel is in right field. And Chase Patterson is doing the catching today with Peters on the hill. And we have a slight delay before we can get the ball game underway. And the reason for that is that Sugarland did not have a first base coach. So taking care of that honor is Beamer Weems, and we can get started. Gary Gaetti, of course, over in the third base coach's box. Rick Hague leading off. The first pitch from Peters drilled into the zone. Strike one called. Bill Reuter, or the judge, as he's known as around these parts, has the plate. The first base umpire is John Harrington, and Dave Speranza is over at third. Check swing, but strike two on the outside corner from Peters. No balls and two strikes from the right-hander, who went 3 1/3 innings against the New Britain Bees in his first start on Tuesday night. He was limited to around 50 pitches there. You heard Rundles tell us earlier today that he is expecting about 70 pitches this afternoon. There's a drive right center field. It is over the head of Logan Schaefer and bouncing up into the screen. He does retrieve and fire back in. It's a double either way. And Hague, who has had a very good series here in Lancaster, is aboard with the double off the 0-2 pitch. And a runner at second base for Sugarland. Nobody out. Brooks Conrad, the left-handed batting second baseman, will come to the plate. For Hague in the series, he now has 4 hits, and all 4 have been for extra bases to 4 different parts of the ballpark. Now Conrad digging in, batting only 153. He has 1 home run. He has driven in 5. Peters fires, and it's a strike, 0-1. Some pitchers will attack at 0-2. Peters did, and Hague was able to square it up pretty well, drive the ball deep into right center field. Schaefer was cheating that way, but the ball was simply hit so hard that Logan couldn't get back on it to make the play on the fly. Ground ball on the right side. Halton will underhand to Peters covering. That is, as we say, a productive out. Hague moves ahead to third with one away. Renee Tassoni, the center fielder, will come to the plate. Tassoni is hitting 365. He has a pair of home runs, one in this series. And Tassoni has knocked in 10 on the campaign. Tanner Peters spent the first 5 years of his professional career in the Oakland A's organization. He got to AAA Nashville. Barnstormers will keep the corners up. Bell and Halton. And the middle of the infield is back. They'll give up a run here early. Hague at third. And the pitch to Tassoni is down and away. Ball one, no strikes. Jeremy Barfield, the designated hitter, is on deck. Barfield had quite the game last night. Early on, it was Barfield on one side and Halton on the other. Others contributed later. Way upstairs, Patterson able to reel it in. He juggled the ball for a moment. No chance for Hague to score. 2 balls, no strikes. Wind is blowing out this afternoon. Once again, it is warm and muggy here in Lancaster, as it has been this entire Memorial Day holiday weekend. No complaints on this end. 2 balls and no strikes. Peters to Tassoni. Ball 3 is low. Rene Tassoni, who homered 2 nights ago here, has yet to see a pitch he can handle. It is 3-0. Runner at third base with 1 out, top half of the first inning. Barfield on deck. After him would be Travis Scott. Peters looks over toward Hague at third. Here's the 3-0 delivery, a strike at the knees. Tassoni will have to see another. Three balls, one strike. The count on Tassoni. Here's the motion and the pitch. This is lifted foul down the first baseline and will carry on into the seats. Three balls and two strikes. Tassoni was born in Toronto, but grew up near Vancouver. One of three Vancouver area players in this league, along with Tyson Gillies, who is on the DL for the Skeeters, and Michael Krause, who went from Lancaster to New Britain. Here comes the payoff pitch to Tassoni. Popped up again. This one might be in play. Patterson coming back. Chase Patterson's got room near the visiting on deck circle and makes the catch for out number two. A huge second out for Tanner Peters, getting through the tough Rene Tassoni with the runner at third base and not allowing that run to score. Now Jeremy Barfield will have to do it with a base hit. Barfield, 297 with seven home runs. He has driven in 23. He hit three balls extremely well last night. A home run to straightaway left. A triple, which short hopped Travis Witherspoon and got by him as he tried to make the shoestring catch. And then that amazing play made by Logan Schaefer in deep left center field in the seventh inning to preserve the tie at that point. First pitch strike. Peters getting it over to Barfield. It is 0-1. Here's the motion. Next offering, a breaking ball that bleeds through Patterson. Runner trying to score. The throw back gets away from Peters, and the run is home. Rick Hague has scored on the play and will have to get an official ruling. My belief is that that one would be a pass ball. That will check in on what Bill Hoffman rules. So it is a ball and a strike on Barfield. And the run comes home without Barfield having to do anything except stand there and take a pitch. Bases are empty now with two outs. The wind, the offering, and the breaking ball is upstairs. We get to two balls and a strike. Sugarland with the run on the board. And it was charged as a wild pitch. Ground ball pulled foul. Two balls and two strikes. So the run is earned. Here's a 2-2 outside. And we go full on Barfield. Three balls and two strikes. The pitch may have bounced. I didn't see it. 3-2. And the Peters delivery is ball four inside. Barfield picks up a walk, and now Travis Scott gets an opportunity here in the first inning. Scott batting 241, three home runs, 11 runs batted in. 2-for-8 with an RBI in this series. He had a huge game against the Barnstormers the first game he played in the series at Sugarland back on April the 27th. He was 4-for-6 with, they gave him four runs batted in. Swing and a miss. It is 0-1. I say that he had the walk-off grand slam officially. There was some dispute about whether or not the ball actually left the ballpark on the fly, but officially it was logged as a grand slam. Nothing in one. The count on Scott. Barfield aborted first base with two outs. He has yet to steal a bag on the year. Peters will fire high. Scott bats at 1-1. Peters did a tremendous job getting the foul out on Tassoni to keep that run from scoring, and then gives it up on the wild pitch. Foul back to the screen. 1-2. Barfield last year spent time with both Camden and Sugarland. Hit an even 300 with nine home runs. He's the runner at first base. Scott, another Atlantic League fixture. in the batter's box. The 1-2 to him. Grounded foul past Weems in the coach's box. And we hold at a ball and two strikes. It seems like Scott has been in this league forever. He started with York, and he's been at Sugarland for quite some time. Makes his home down that way now. Here comes the 1-2. Peters gets a fly ball toward left center field. Backing up is Jackson. Coming in is Schaefer, and the center fielder takes charge, and he makes the catch for the final out. It's one run, though, on one hit with no errors. One man is left on base through one half inning here at Clipper Magazine Stadium. It is Sugarland 1, Lancaster nothing.
All right, we have our Cottonhour's Home Appliance Center. Guess the number. Northern Lancaster County, behind the field door.
Foot massage or 90-minute shiatsu, the chicken special or the Maine lobster, an entry-level luxury sedan or the new 2016 Lexus ES. There's a difference between luxury-ish and luxurious. The luxuriously transformed 2016 Lexus ES, with available features like the Lexus Safety System Plus, you won't just live a little, you'll live a lot. See Bobby Rahal Lexus in Mechanicsburg.
A nice patch of grass, a sloping hillside, and a ball game. Is there any better way to spend your weekend? Well, thanks to Wise Markets and the Lancaster Barnstormers, you can do just that with the Grass Pass package, backed this year by popular demand. For only $15, you get a lawn ticket, a delicious Hatfield hot dog, chips, and a fountain soda, plus an exclusive limited edition Barnstormers fleece blanket. Just stop by any participating Wise Market location to purchase your Grass Pass package.
Logan Schaefer leads off the bottom of the first inning for the Barnstormers, and the pitch from Sean Gallagher is dealt for a strike, 0-1. Gallagher has worked quite a long time here in the Atlantic League, in and out. He has a 13-16 career record in this league. Pop fly foul down the left field line into the bullpen of the Sugarland Skeeters. Gallagher has Schaefer at 0-2. This season, Gallagher is 2-3. 36 and a third innings, 36 hits, 11 earned runs. He has walked 17, and he has struck out 15. 2.73 is Gallagher's ERA. Two strikes to Schaefer, a check swing, and he ticked it foul, says Bill Reuter. And Schaefer has gone on strikes on three pitches. He definitely checked on the swing. Reuter said he brushed it foul. Wilfredo Rodriguez held on, and Logan Schaefer stands in the batter's box discussing that with Mr. Reuter for a little while. Patrick Palmero is the third baseman. Rick Hague is short. Brooks Conrad at second. Travis Scott over at first. The outfield has Kent Mathis in left with Rene Tassoni in center. And Johan Lamonta is the right fielder. Wilfredo Rodriguez doing the catching. Rich Rundle's now taking up for Schaefer. In the discussion with the plate umpire, Bill Reuter, we have one out, nobody on. Jeff Coburnus steps to the plate. Coburnus batting 265. He has one home run, and he has knocked in 18 on the season. Six of those runs batted in have come in the six games against Sugarland. Here's the wind. The pitch by Gallagher ripped into left field through the hole and a base hit. It appeared to be in Coburnus's eyes, but he managed to get it into play, driving it past the third baseman, Palmero. And now one of this league's top base stealers is aboard with one out. Caleb Gindel, the right fielder, will step in. Gindel at 341. He has three home runs. He has knocked in 20. Coburnus in a multi-way tie for second in stolen bases here in the Atlantic League. To Gindel, high and outside, almost in pitch-out territory. but Rodriguez didn't make that early movement to his left that would have indicated that they had a pitch out on. Josh Whitaker, the left fielder, waits on deck. Gallagher ready to go. Coburnus takes off. He got a bad start. Here's the throw by Rodriguez, and they got him at second base. Jeff Coburnus seemed to spin his wheels a little bit when he tried to get going there. He didn't get the greatest jump, and Rodriguez on a high outside fastball again to Gindel made a strong throw right on the mark, and Coburnus is cut down. Two outs, and Gindel left up there at 2-0. The pitch to him is dribbled on the third base side. With it is Gallagher, and his throw cuts down Gindel. He out 1-3. Little bit of promise here in the first inning, but nothing going on. No runs, one hit, no errors, nobody left on base. We're at the end of one here at Clipper Magazine Stadium this afternoon. Sugarland has the early lead, 1-0.
After church or before a Sunday ball game, drop by the Federal Tap House in Lancaster for their elegant Sunday brunch. Their brunch menu has something for everyone, which includes options such as stuffed French toast, Tap House Benedict's over burgers, crab cakes or short ribs, breakfast burritos, and huevos rancheros, not to mention select items off of their already great menu, which include their wood-fired pizzas. That's at Federal Tap House, 201 North Queen Street in downtown Lancaster, or at their other location on 2nd Street in Harrisburg. Served from 10:30 a.m. until 2 p.m.
Two of rock's most iconic names join forces. Leonard Skinner. Peter Frampton. Together in concert. June 8th, Clipper Magazine Stadium. Playing all the hits. Tickets on sale now at amtshows.com, 800-648-4102, or at the AMT box office. Presented by AMT Concerts.
Kent Mathis to start the second inning against Tanner Peters. Mathis, the right-handed batting left fielder, 252 for the season. Kent with 5 home runs, and he has driven in 24 on the year. Man who spent the second half of last season right here as a Barnstormer, product of the University of Alabama, and like the man he is facing, the Oakland A's organization. Mathis, LaMonta, and Palmeiro, 6-7-8 for the Skeeters in the box here in the second inning. First pitch strike from Peters. Tanner regularly getting that first pitch into the zone. 0-1 the count. Peters coming right back, and Mathis looks at a fastball off the inside part of the plate. It is 1-1. Bell behind the bag at third with Mathis batting. The middle infielders Jackson and Coburnus very deep. The outfield set straight away. 1-1. Peters with the offering, and it's hit off the end of the bat, lofted out to left center field. Logan Schaefer, an easy play to his right. 1-1 here in the second. And Johan LaMonta will step to the plate. LaMonta hitting 217. He has a couple of home runs on the year. He has knocked in 10. Left-handed batter, he too has been around the Atlantic League for some time. Pitch to the left-handed batter, fired down and away. 1-0. Oh yeah, bright pink to red bat in the possession of Mr. LaMonta up there. And he hits a high fly ball out the left. This will travel some, but it's playable. Settling back, Whitaker, 2-2. Second inning has gone by quickly so far. And that will bring on Patrick Palmeiro. 219 on the year with a home run and 11 knocked in. Right-handed batter all the way is Palmeiro. He has his home run against the Barnstormers that came in Texas on that opening road trip. Here is the wind and the Peters pitch. Foul ball back into the net. One strike on Palmeiro. It is 1-0 Sugarland in the top of the second inning. Rick Hague led off the game with a double and eventually scored on a wild pitch. We talk about productive outs. There was one for Brooks Conrad in there that moved the runner to third. Second strike as Peters reaches the outer edge on Palmeiro. It is 0-2. Tanner ready to go from the far first base side of the rubber. And he comes right after another batter at 0-2. This is fouled away. And some excellent velocity there from Tanner Peters. He gave up the double to Hague on an 0-2 pitch back in the first inning. Some in baseball would frown upon that. Old school, you didn't throw the 0-2 pitch where a batter could reach it. 0-2 on Palmeiro. He gets jammed here. Pop up, Halton comes over, but there is no play. It's into the crowd. Patrick Palmeiro continues to bat at no balls and two strikes. Not a bad turnout today here on Sunday. It's also Bark in the Park Day, so occasionally you'll hear one of our four-legged friends in the background. No balls, two strikes. Tanner Peters brings home a breaking ball. It misses the outer corner. Ball one on Patrick Palmeiro. Palmeiro from Colleyville, Texas. There's another foul ball to the right. He and Peters locked in this battle at 1-2. Barnstormers have won in this series 6-5 and 7-4. High fly ball hit pretty well by Palmeiro out the left. Going back with it is Whitaker. He still got room in front of the track to make the catch. Four fly ball outs in a row for Tanner Peters. And the Skeeters go down 1-2-3 here in the top half of the second inning. We're through 1.5. Sugarland still up by the score of 1-0.
It's baseball season, and no one is more excited about that than we here at Lancaster Bible College, proud sponsor of Lancaster Barnstormers Baseball. At Lancaster Bible College, you can earn your associate's, bachelor's, master's, seminary, or doctoral degrees through a distinctly biblical lens in areas like leadership, communication, business administration, social work, education, pastoral studies, music, and many more. Find out how you can take the next step in your educational journey to earn a degree from LBC. Visit us on the web at lbc.edu. We look forward to seeing you at Barnstormers Games this season.
What's more fun and exciting than playing Pennsylvania Millions with top prizes of $1 million? Winning on the spot.
Woohoo! I won!
So if you can't wait to win, then don't wait to play. Pennsylvania Millions from the Pennsylvania Lottery for a chance to win up to $1 million on the spot. The Pennsylvania Lottery. Keep on scratching. Players must be 18 or older. Please play responsibly. Benefits older Pennsylvanians every day.
Josh Whitaker, Josh Bell, and Sean Halton stepping in for the Barnstormers against Sean Gallagher as we break into the bottom half of the second inning. Whitaker getting things started. He's down to 278, five home runs and 16 driven in. Whitaker hasn't been heard from much in the current series. He is just 1 out of 8. Defense very deep against him. Gallagher with the pitch, and it lights up the outside corner. Strike one. Sean Gallagher got through the first inning on only 6 pitches. What helped out was Jeff Coburn is being thrown out stealing. Ball one is high and a fastball, 1-1. Coburn is now 13 for 16 on the year. Ball two is low to Whitaker. Two balls and a strike. Very good, solid player is Whitaker. Here's the wind, the 2-1. Fastball upstairs, 3-1. He does strike out more than your average player, but when you've got as much power as he does, it's forgivable. Here is the 3-1 offering, swing and a miss there. That might have been ball four. Full count pitch due to the left fielder as the Barnstormers trying to make up this one-run deficit here in the second inning. The payoff, and Whitaker sends it skyward, shallow center field. Coming on for it is Tassoni. He makes the catch. Whitaker is dispatched after having the 3-1 edge in the count. Josh Bell will come to the plate. Bell had the night off last night. He's a 256 hitter for the season with a pair of home runs and 17 runs driven in. Talked about the two home runs that Halton hit last night. The second one was crushed. It cleared the right side of the batter's eye. Now to Bell, a strike on the outside corner, but I don't think we'll see one as long for a while as Bell hit the one against York, clearing the back ad wall in deep right center. Here's the motion, and Bell 0-1, sliced foul down the left field line, back to the top of the hill. Gallagher has him at 0-2. Sean Gallagher is known to get off to very good starts, at least against the Barnstormers. He had a shutout into the sixth inning in game three of the 2014 championship series, as you may recall, and then Jacobo got to him for the three-run homer that vaulted Lancaster back into that game. To Bell, 1-2. He swings and misses at the high fastball. The second strikeout for Sean Gallagher on the day. Gallagher had walked more than he had struck out coming into the afternoon. Sean Halton to the plate. He's had the best series of anyone on either side. 4-for-8 with two home runs, a double, a triple, and 5 runs batted in. And this guy has power to all fields. He actually translates pretty well to here because he does hit the other way quite nicely. Fastball is up from Gallagher, ball one and no strikes. I think both Whitaker and Bell, it has seemed to me, have helped Gallagher out a little bit going after the high fastball this inning. Now, right straight through, and Halton takes a strike. The count evens at 1-1. Mike McDade, the designated hitter, is on deck. Sugarland ahead by a run here in the second. The motion, and Halton gets a breaking ball and loops a foul over on the right side and out of play. One ball, two strikes. Gallagher has only averaged a little more than 5 innings per start this year. Here's a 1-2, breaking ball outside. They'll ask for help down at first base, but John Harrington correctly turns down the request. Sean Halton bats at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Here's the offering, fastball up and in. And Halton would not cooperate with Gallagher, 3-2. Sean Gallagher has spent plenty of time in the major leagues, 4 years there with 4 different teams, Cubs, Oakland, San Diego, and Pittsburgh. A 10-10 major league record, high and inside, and I don't believe that actually hit Whitaker, or Halton rather, he got out of the way, but he is aboard with the walk. And Mike McDade will come to the plate. McDade at 252 with 6 runs batted in. He's hitting very steadily as of late. But you do look for the long ball out of McDade, and that has not come yet. It will. Halton leads off first. Here's the pitch, and McDade gets a fastball up. Ball one and no strikes. Mike currently on a 6-game hitting streak, but only 7 hits in that stretch. He's batting .327 in his last 13 games. Here's the ball one pitch, swing and a miss at a breaking ball down and in. He thought he had something to manage, but that ball had a nasty little curl on it at the last minute. One ball and one strike. Halton, not much of a base stealing threat. He's got the lead off first, being held by Scott. To McDade, here's the 1-1. Fastball is again high. And it appears that Gallagher has lost that pitch for the moment. And again, it looked to me like the Barnstormers did help him out on it earlier in the inning. But Halton would not, and McDade has laid off a couple. 2-1 now. That is ball three up and away. Catcher Chase Patterson waits on deck. Patterson had his best game of the season the one time that he faced Sugarland. He was 3-for-4 in the series finale at Constellation Field. Throw goes to first, keeping Halton honest. McDade needs to select the right pitch here. Gallagher ready to go, 3-1, and McDade elevates it to dead center field. Easy play for Tassoni. Started back, then recovered those steps. Right there to make the play. No runs, no hits, no errors. One man left on base. We're done with two. Sugarland still up 1-0.
It's nice out and you just want to relax after a day at work. The Lancaster Barnstormers have a great idea. For Monday through Thursday home games, the Barnstormers have super dinner and a ball game deals at Clipper Magazine Stadium. On Monday, join us for an all-you-can-eat pork barbecue dinner in the Hess's Picnic Pavilion, or choose chicken on Tuesday, all for just $20, including your game ticket. And new on Monday, it's pizza, beer, and pinball all night long. Then on Wednesdays, it's Hatfield hot dogs for just $1 each with 2-for-1 burgers on Thursdays. Call 717-509-HITS or go to LancasterBarnstormers.com for more details.
After you juggle the kids, sports, homework, housework, and squeeze in a moment for yourself, there isn't much time left to plan activities to keep your family having fun together. So give yourself a break and head to Strasburg Railroad, where the 45-minute steam train ride is just the beginning. There are family-friendly train events, vintage baseball, shop tours, a steampunk weekend, plus our popular Day Out with Thomas trains. The fun is as endless as your imagination. Reserve your tickets at StrasburgRailroad.com.
Barnstormers made a couple of defensive changes in the inning break. Justin Jackson has gone over to second base. Kevin Ahrens inserted into the ball game at shortstop. He thought he was getting the afternoon off. That means that Jeff Coburnus is out of the lineup. I don't know if it had anything to do with the steal attempt back in the first inning or not. Maybe something got tweaked there, but you don't want to read too much into it. Here is Wilfredo Rodriguez, the catcher. In the lead off the third, Tanner Peters delivers, and that ball is hit a ways to right center field. It is carrying way back, it goes, and the walls will not contain it. That is a home run to center field for Wilfredo Rodriguez, his first home run of the season, and boy, that was a long home run. So it is 2-0 now in favor of the Sugarland Skeeters. That ball just picked up some lift and kept right on going. A home run for Rodriguez. Back around to the top of the order, and Ricky Haig stepping in. Here's the motion, Peters to the plate. And that is upstairs to Haig, who doubled and scored back in the first inning. It's now 2-0. That is only the 10th home run for Wilfredo Rodriguez in his career. Swing and a miss. One ball and one strike. One more in winter ball in Puerto Rico this past offseason. Hague's 1-1, Peters fools Hague. It is one ball and two strikes. Nothing cheap about that Rodriguez home run, however. One, two, swing and a miss. Oh, Peters fires back against Hague and gets his first strikeout of the day. One away, Brooks Conrad will step in. Conrad grounded out his first time up, but that ground out was important, building the first run as he hit the ball on the right side. Moving Hague from second to third, and he could score from there on a wild pitch. Tanner Peters starts him off with a breaking ball and a good one for a strike. 0-1. Tassoni is on deck. Fastball up and away, a check swing, he didn't go. David Speranza concurs with the original call. One ball, one strike to Conrad. He was looking for his first hit of the year against the Barnstormers. He is 0 for 12 in the season series. Swing and a miss, make it 1-2. But batting only 153 overall. Peters brings it home low. Two balls and two strikes. Two nights ago here, the Barnstormers got Conrad for a huge second out. In the top of the eighth inning, Scott Gracie was in a major bind. Bases loaded with one out and the one-run lead. He got Conrad to pop up. Got out of the inning from there with a strikeout of Cordero. Ball three, misses low to Conrad. To Sony on deck, Peters wants, and I would have to say pretty much needs this out. One away, nobody on board. 3-2. Tanner brings it home low and gives up his second walk. That's unusual. His career walks per nine innings rate is 2, and he's already walked 2 in the ball game this afternoon. Rene Tassoni comes to the plate. Tassoni fouled out to catcher Chase Patterson back in the first inning. Skeeters are up 2-0 here in the third, and an opportunity to do some more harm to Sony and then Barfield, one of the more dangerous 3-4 combinations that this league has to offer. Fastball for a strike is 0-1. Not that the Barnstormers are terribly shaky in that department either, with Gindel and Whitaker. They're pretty dangerous as well. No balls and a strike. High fly ball left center field. Schaefer has this one gauged. Tassoni will be retired and playing it halfway and ducking back into first is Conrad. Two are out and Jeremy Barfield will come in. Peters has given up 2 hits today, but they've both been for extra bases. It's much the way the Barnstormers have played this series. Lancaster first 2 games of the series, only 16 hits. That's extraordinarily low for this ball club. But of those 16 hits, 9 had been for extra bases, and they were parlaying those into several runs here. Slider is away, ball 1 and no strikes on Barfield. Brooks Conrad, a runner at first base, has not tried to steal at all this season. Sugarland isn't much of a base running team. To Barfield, fastball misses low. It is 2-0. Travis Scott, the on-deck batter. Sugarland up by a pair. The Barnstormers have had a single runner in each inning so far. Nobody has arrived safely at second against Gallagher. Two balls, no strikes. Barfield awaiting, and there is a pitch on the outer edge. Barfield probably smart to take that one. It is two balls and a strike. Peters really hasn't paid much attention to Brooks Conrad. He's inching away, trying to distract the right-hander. Ball three is low and outside. 3-1. Barnstormers with Patterson, Jackson, and Schaefer in the bottom half of this third inning. Not too far behind yet with a lot of time to go. To Barfield, 3-1. Smash on the right side. Jackson has no chance to get it. It's into right field, a base hit. Conrad ahead to second. Barfield is on board, and Travis Scott will step in. Scott fly to center field, back in the first. Five total base runners now for the Sugarland Skeeters on the day, and now you really need the third out of this inning. Barfield reaching base for the second straight time. He's had a nice series here. 5 out of 10 for Jeremy Barfield. To Travis Scott, outside, ball one and no strikes. Peters over 50 on the pitch count here through 2 2/3 innings. I'm sure the Barnstormers were hoping for 5 innings out of him on his 70 pitches. It doesn't look like that's going to happen. Ball one and nothing. And a Scott, ball two, misses low, 2 balls, no strikes. Peters' one win coming against the York Revolution in a relief appearance back on May 16th. Two balls, no strikes with two outs, two on. Peters to the plate, and that ball is ripped deep to right field. Way back it goes, and the walls will not contain it. Travis Scott, a three-run homer, second home run of the inning for Sugarland, and the Skeeters have jumped ahead in this ball game 5-0. Conrad and Barfield come around in front of the Scott home run, his fourth of the season, and second against the Barnstormers. Kent Mathis will bat with two outs and the bases empty. Well, the Barnstormers getting knocked around by the home runs in their own ballpark. They've been out homered here this year. That hasn't happened often. Fly ball out the left. Calling for it is Whitaker. He'll put it away, and a very quick end of the inning, but not before 4 runs score on 3 hits, 2 of them home runs, no errors, nobody left on base. We will head to the bottom half of the third inning here this afternoon. The score is Sugarland 5. And the Barnstormers, nothing.
Localflavor.com, local flavor, localflavor.com, local flavor.
Excuse me. Are you saying localflavor.com?
Oh, yeah, it's where I save big bucks on all kinds of things. Home improvement projects, dining out, family fun, electronics, jewelry, clothing. I even bought my wife a fancy spa package for half price.
Half price?
Yep, you know all the deals you find in Clipper Magazine.
I love Clipper Magazine.
Well, they're all on localflavor.com, too. And you can get them right on your phone, thanks to localflavor.com's mobile app. Here, take a look.
Well, this app is amazing. Look at all these restaurants, amusement parks, car washes, fitness centers. This is worth sharing about.
Exactly. Localflavor.com online, the Local Flavor mobile app, and Clipper Magazine together. It's like a triple play.
Do the cheer again. I'm in.
Localflavor.com, Local Flavor. Come on, everybody. Localflavor.com, Local Flavor. Localflavor.com, Local Flavor.
Thank you.
Not quite the start that the Lancaster Barnstormers were looking for here today. They're down 5-0 as we go to the bottom of the third inning. Chase Patterson will lead off for Lancaster. Patterson 7-for-26, 269 average with three doubles and two runs batted in. Gallagher to the plate, and his fastball once again runs in high. He had trouble with that all last inning. Ball one and no strikes to Patterson. 3-for-4 the last time he faced the Sugarland Skeeters. Now ball two is upstairs. Two balls and no strikes. That game also produced his only two runs batted into the year. Now a fly ball out to right field. Backing up on it is LaMonta, and he'll squeeze right at the front lip of the warning track. Patterson goes down, one away. Justin Jackson, the shortstop, will come to the plate, or now the second baseman. Jackson is 4-for-18, a couple of doubles, hasn't driven in a run. Of course, he started the year as a pitcher, but the Barnstormers had the need for him to come in and be the utility infielder as well. First pitch strike, it is 0-1. That need is probably going to go away in the next few days as Lance Zawadzki is almost ready. Ground ball left side toward the hole. Backhanded pickup made by the shortstop, Hag. He fires on to get Jackson. Two up and two down here in the third. And back around to the top of the order, and Logan Schaefer. Schaefer struck out and struck out questioning the strikeout. Back in the first inning, it was ruled that he foul tipped the third strike on a check swing. Two outs, nobody aboard. The Barnstormers already behind by five here today. Up and away to Schaefer. Ball one and no strikes. Barnstormers in their last daytime game lost 9-1. That was on Thursday. Strike to the outer corner, it's 1-1. But they have a winning record overall under the sunshine. A swing and a miss. And Schaefer drops behind in the count 1-2 against Gallagher. Sean Gallagher starting to get into cruise control. The Barnstormers have to find something to flip the switch on this ball game before it completely gets away from them. To Schaefer, here's the 1-2. Fastball is upstairs, two balls and two strikes. We saw a game like this the other night. The Barnstormers were up 6-1 in the third inning, seemed to have everything going their way. And Sugarland ended up with the tying run in scoring position each of the last four innings. They just could never push that man across. Ball three is high and outside. Schaefer bats 3-2. Kevin Ahrens is on deck. Ahrens thought he was getting the afternoon off. Ground ball to second base. With it is Conrad. Quick flip to first, a 1-2-3 inning. Gallagher cruising through the Barnstormers. He's faced one over the minimum through three innings. And at the end of three, it is the Sugarland Skeeters 5 and the Barnstormers nothing.
All right, Lancaster, this is the PSEC.
The National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown is the place where baseball legends live forever. It's where the exciting moments of today stand along the iconic tales of the past. With new exhibits and artifacts telling incredible stories, the Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum is a must-see destination for fans of all ages. Baseball in Cooperstown. Oh, my. Plan your visit today. Check out baseballhall.org.
Top-level soccer is returning to Clipper Magazine Stadium. Enjoy the world's game at Lancaster's premier family entertainment facility through the spring and summer seasons. Come see the City Islanders Football Club take on United Soccer League rivals the Richmond Kickers on Friday, July 8th. Two nights later, the City Islanders will look to defend their home pitch in Lancaster from a second invasion of the Toronto Football Club. Tickets for these two events are available through the Two Dudes box office by calling 717-509-HITS or by going online to LancasterBarnstormers.com. Don't miss out on these special events.
Logan Schaefer hobbled back out to his center field. We do have Travis Witherspoon still available if Schaefer could not continue, but he's sticking it out. Looked like he pulled up a little bit at first base and noticeably was hobbling as he ran back out the center. 5 runs, 4 hits, no errors, 1 left for the Skeeters. No runs, 1 hit, no errors, and 1 man left the board for the Barnstormers here for through the first 3 innings. Johan LaMonta leads off the 4th. LaMonta flied out the left field back in the 2nd inning. Tanner Peters ready to go and curls the first pitch across nicely. It is 0-1. The home runs bit him last inning. Leadoff shot the center by Wilfredo Rodriguez, and then Travis Scott skipped one off the top of the picnic tents. A 3-run blast later on. LaMonta fouling a pitch off down the left field side. It is 0-2, and the Barnstormers have left-hander Ryan Denick warming up in the bullpen. Well, maybe I'd better double-check that. Maybe it's Yavoli. High pop-up. Third base side and just inside fair territory. Halfway to the plate is Bell. He retires LaMonta, 1 away. Patrick Palmeiro coming to the plate. Palmeiro flied out the left field in the 2nd. One out, nobody on base here in the 4th. Peters will try to get every out he can. Breaking ball, good for a strike on Palmeiro. It is 0-1. Just likely got his pitches up somewhat back in the 3rd inning. That's lined into center field. Palmeiro with a base hit. 5 hits total now for the Sugarland Skeeters. 1 out runner, and here's Wilfredo Rodriguez. Boy, did he flex his muscles back in the 3rd inning. A 22-year-old from Carolina, Puerto Rico. He had a blast to center field, but it also gives you the indication the ball is traveling pretty well today. And if Gallagher and the Sugarland bullpen should happen to falter, the Barnstormers have that opportunity to come back. The home run definitely can be a thing today. Strike one on Rodriguez. Peters has only gotten 1 ground ball, though, in the game. He has walked 2, so not the afternoon that he would have been expecting, nor the one the Barnstormers were expecting out of him. Next pitch, fastball runs inside. Ball 1 and strike 1 on Wilfredo Rodriguez. He was much smoother, was Peters, in his start Tuesday against the New Britain Bees for 3 1/3 innings. Gave up 3 hits in the 2nd, at 1 run, one of those an infield single. He is down low, and Rodriguez bats at 2 balls and a strike. Now Lancaster with the left-handed action in the bullpen. The 2nd digit is a 4. I guess it's Yavoli. Now, there's a beard. Pickoff throw to first, and Halton saves it. So I can only see from my new vantage point here, half of them down there. Ball 3 is down low, 3-1. Peters got the first out here in the 4th inning pretty easily. Seems to be laboring some now. 3 balls, 1 strike on Wilfredo Rodriguez. Left-handed action in the bullpen. Peters probably will get Rodriguez and Haig, and then a change could be made. Runner from first base goes. Chopper to shortstop, handled by Ahrens. He's got to go all the way across the diamond and gets Rodriguez 6-3. Palmeiro moved ahead to 2nd. It's almost as if Sugarland had tea leaves right there. They gained a base. They didn't stay out of the double play. There would not have been time to make the feed to Jackson and relay it back to first. Rodriguez got down that line quickly. So Rick Haig is the batter with 2 outs. Palmeiro the runner at 2nd base. And the left-handed action continues in the Lancaster bullpen. batters is Loda Hag, who has doubled and struck out. Ball one, no strike. Sugarland leading 5-0 here in the fourth inning. Two outs, Palmeiro at second. Peters certainly would at least like to end the fourth inning. Fastball good for a strike. It is 1-1. Tanner Peters has good velocity, good movement, but the command, I don't think, has been what he would like. And he generally doesn't walk very many. But today, two. There's a pitch low, and a pickoff attempt by Patterson ends up in center field. Sprinting for third is Palmeiro. Schaefer's throw is late and off the mark. An error will be charged to Patterson. Meanwhile, it is 2-1 on Hag. Hopefully that error doesn't end up leading to another run. Two balls, one strike to Rick Hag. Two outs, Palmeiro over at third. And to this point, a tough afternoon for the Lancaster Barnstormers. Schaefer shifts over toward right center. Hag has hit the ball that way a couple of times in this series. The Peters pitch in the dirt, stop made by Patterson. 3-1. Peters into the motion, and there's a high fly ball out to right field. Fairly deep, Gindel low, shades on the warning track, has a play. He makes the catch. Peters gets through the fourth unscathed. No runs, a hit, an error, and one man left on base. We're headed to the bottom half of the fourth inning with the score Sugarland 5 and Lancaster nothing.
The Federal Tap House is a great place to stop by after a Barnstormers game and continue your enjoyable evening in downtown Lancaster. Featuring 100 beers on tap, including many craft beers from here in central PA, the Federal Tap House has something for everyone's palate, not to mention a full bar and elegant wine selection for the non-beer geeks in the group. For the entire lineup of brews, check online at federaltaphouse.com. That's at Federal Tap House, 201 North Queen Street, just blocks from Clipper Magazine Stadium, or at their other location in Harrisburg.
Hey kids, thanks to Isaac's, you can be part of the Barnstormers. The Isaac's Barnyard Bunch is quite a deal. You get lawn vouchers for 6 games, 6 kids park passes, the chance to go on the field with your Barnstormers during the national anthem on 2 different nights, and a Barnyard Bunch t-shirt. But there's more. Any Barnyard Bunch member will get 2 vouchers for kids meals at your favorite Lancaster County Isaac's Deli. You get all of this for only $25. Even better, if you sign up at your local Isaac's, you save $5 more. So join the Barnyard Bunch today.
Kevin Ahrens, Caleb Gindel, and Josh Whitaker will step in the home half of the fourth inning for the Barnstormers. Ahrens batting for the first time in the ball game this afternoon. He replaced Jeff Coburnus, who singled, was thrown out stealing, and then about an inning later came out of the game. First pitch is high to Ahrens, ball 1-0. Kevin has just been such a steady contributor on this team. Gallagher misses high again, ball 2. He has been up there quite a bit this afternoon. He has only walked the one. To Ahrens, 2-0 pitch. That is smashed into left field. And a leadoff single for the Barnstormers in the bottom half of the fourth inning. Kevin Ahrens, who started the afternoon hitting 279, will lift that a bit. Caleb Gindel steps in. Gindel with a partial swing roller to the third base side of the mound. Retired 1-3 back in the first frame. Kevin Ahrens leading off first base. Not quite the steal threat that Coburnus was in that same slot. Now Gindel with a swing and a foul ball back into the screen. He is down a strike at his 0-1. Josh Whitaker on deck, then Josh Bell as the Barnstormers try to solve Sean Gallagher and get back into this game here in the fourth inning. Ahrens has Lancaster off to a good start. Daisuke Yoshida coaching first. DJ Boston is over at third. To Gindel, 0-1, low, and a good stop made by Rodriguez. He's had himself an afternoon. One ball and one strike. Perfect throw to get Coburnus, a home run. Nice block there by Rodriguez. That's, of course, part of the job description. It's not necessarily going over and above to block those pitches. You're supposed to do it, but sometimes they do get away. Outside, two balls and one strike on Caleb Gindel. The count turns in the favor of the Barnstormer right fielder. Barnstormers wearing their Sunday jerseys today, which were designed by kids from Penn State Hershey. High pop up, foul territory, third base side. Palmeiro charging over. He's not going to get to it. It's in the seats. Gindel batting 2-2. What I like most about these jerseys is you can read the numbers. Two balls, two strikes. Ahrens leading from first base. Gallagher ready to go. Gindel looks at a fastball away, 3-2. Gallagher has walked one, struck out two today. Coming in, he had walked more than he had struck out, 17-15. Gindel awaits a payoff pitch. Ahrens is going to take off, and Gindel spoils it foul into the screen. Down by five, the Barnstormers putting a runner in motion. I like it. Meanwhile, the left-hander continues to tune up from time to time in the bullpen. I have to believe that Tanner Peters is done for the day. He reached 70 pitches. And Gindel gets ball four. Good eye. That one close, and Lancaster now has runners at first and second. Translation, a chance to get back in this game. Josh Whitaker to the plate. Whitaker fly to center field, back in the second. Then Josh Bell and Sean Halton. So you've got some pretty significant power stepping in with runners already on base. You don't want anybody just thinking about that. Right now, you're just trying to extend this inning and maybe getting one home. Breaking ball cut on and missed. Whitaker down a strike. It is 0-1. I have Gallagher for just 49 pitches in this game. To Whitaker, breaking ball chases him out of the batter's box. Ball one and strike one. Infield set, double play depth for Sugarland. The Barnstormers looking for something a whole lot better than the double play. 1-1, Whitaker takes a breaking ball for a second strike. It is 1-2. He may have been looking for a fastball there. Five out of his last 32 is Whitaker. Pop up foul and out of play. He'll stay in against Gallagher with a count of one ball and two strikes. The Barnstormers, to get back in this game, need to score one or two here. I mean, a seven-run inning like Kansas City had in the ninth last night would be special, but you want one or two out of this, certainly. 1-2 on Whitaker, breaking ball, line down the left field line, and that is a foul ball, says the plate umpire Bill Reuter. It also shattered Whitaker's bat. A hooking line drive off a broken bat just didn't have quite enough energy to stay fair. It lost steam and as a result faded across the line. He didn't miss by more than a foot. Whitaker will come back and face a 1-2 offering. Ahrens is on at second. Gindel is aboard at first here in the fourth inning. The only threat of the day faced by Sean Gallagher. Josh Whitaker back in at 1-2. Man with 14 extra base hits on the season, as does the guy behind him have, Josh Bell. 1-2, swing and a miss. Whitaker is gone on strikes. That is the third for Gallagher on the day. And here is Bell. He struck out back in the second inning. Sean Halton is on deck. Halton has 6 extra base hits, but in far fewer at-bats. You've got some real legitimate power in the middle of this Barnstormer batting order. It's been more doubles power than home run power. To Bell, ground ball, slowly hit, knocked down to the backhanded side by the first baseman, Scott. He was looking to turn two, still gets one on the 3-1 conversion. Halton will bat with Ahrens to third, Gindel to second, and now 2 outs. Halton walked in the second. Aaron's up the line from third. Gindel is off second to Halton, inside and low, ball one. On deck is the designated hitter, Mike McDade. Barnstormers now need a base hit to score this inning. Here's a 1-0 breaking ball, grounded to short. Looks like they will not. The throw pulls the first baseman Scott off the bag, but right into Halton. 6-3. Lancaster lets a big opportunity go by here in the fourth inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and the Barnstormers leave 2. We are through 4, and it's all Sugarland this afternoon. The Skeeters are up 5-0.
Floor it, punch it, hit it. Put the pedal to the metal. Burn rubber, step on the gas. No matter how you say it, you'll definitely feel it once you're behind the wheel of the powerful Lexus IS 300. With 255 horsepower and the confidence of all-wheel drive, it does all its talking on the road. The new Lexus IS 300 all-wheel drive. Once driven, there's no going back. See Bobby Rahal Lexus in Mechanicsburg.
Hi everyone, Adam Gocknauer here from Gocknauer Appliances, proud to be a sponsor yet again for our hometown Lancaster Barnstormers. We support them on the field and every one of you across Lancaster County with the very best appliances in the area. We are proud to be in our 67th year and 4 generations of family ownership, all to serve you and take care of all your appliance needs. Come see us at 5939 Main Street in East Petersburg or on our website at gocknauers.com.
Barnstormers have gone to left-hander Ryan Denick, the winning pitcher last night, and hoping that similar fortune will follow here today. The Barnstormers have a long way back in this game. Down 5-0 as we go into the fifth inning. Tanner Peters got the start. He worked through 4, gave up 5 hits and 5 runs. He was plagued by the home run ball in the third inning. He gave up 2 there. Overall, walk 2, was charged with a wild pitch, and Peters struck out 1. Brooks Conrad will lead off against Denick. Conrad, a switch hitter, he'll step in from the right side of the plate. 0 for 1 with a walk on the day. Danick, 6-footer from now Edgewood, Kentucky, originally from North Olmsted, Ohio. His first pitch is lifted foul out of play on the right. Conrad trailing by a strike. It is 0-1. Danick now 1-1 on the year. He's given up 8 hits, 6 earned runs in 5 2/3 innings. He got a strikeout last night. It was his first of the season. Fanning Rick Hague in the 7th inning. Slow roller past the mound. Tough play. Jackson hustling in. Makes the backhanded flip to Halton. That gets away. Patterson racing down to back it up. It'll be an infield single for Brooks Conrad leading off the 5th inning. A check swing, miss hit, roller past the mound on the right side, and Jackson was cheating toward the middle. He raced over, tried to flip it backhanded over his head, and he missed Halton by a lot, several feet. Conrad is on base. Rene Tassoni steps in at 0 for 2. Barnstormers having one of those days where not much is going right. Infield set, double play depth. Danick to Tassoni, fouled away. One strike. Take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. Somerset playing the third of four at York, and the Revs are up 5-0 in the 8th inning this afternoon. New Britain and Long Island tied at 3. They have reached the top of the 5th inning. Ball is low. One ball and one strike on Tassoni. Southern Maryland and Bridgeport are in the top of the 6th, knotted at 1. Well, the Barnstormers may end up losing the ground that they gained last night. We'll be halfway through the half and 4 behind York if something doesn't turn around today. Lancaster is still trying to break free from the shackles of that 8-game early season losing streak that completely ruined a hot start. The Barnstormers coming into this one had won 9 of 13. To the outside edge and a second strike on Tassoni. It is 1-2. Danick is starting to pitch so much better than when he first got here. This bullpen is really starting to take shape and I think looking pretty good right now. Just missing outside, and Tassoni bats at 2-2. Pete Andrelzik is such a key piece of the bullpen, and to see him pitch the way he did last night, getting the Barnstormers out of a bases loaded one out jam in the 5th inning, it's such a huge element. Strike 3 called on the next one, and Tassoni will bark. Danick picks up the called third strike, first out here in the 5th inning. Jeremy Barfield will come to the plate. Barfield has walked and he has singled and scored. Gary Gaetti steering Tassoni back to the dugout.
Designated hitter Jeremy Barfield.
Rene Tassoni was a little bit peeved over that last call, I would say. Runner at first base, Conrad with one away. He has shown no indication that he might be running, and he doesn't hear. Ground ball, second base, bobbled by Jackson. He's got to get the out at first. Lost a chance to get the lead man and maybe the entire double play. The out 4-3, Conrad ahead to second, and Travis Scott will come to the plate. Scott with the big hit of the day, a 3-run home run. Back in the 3rd inning. Those were the last runs we have seen today. Scott with 8 of his 14 ribbies on the season against the Barnstormers. He hasn't hit for a high average against Lancaster over the years, but boy, has he had some major hits, either for York or for Sugarland in the season series. Two outs, Conrad at second. Ryan Denick to the plate, and he has Scott fooled. No balls and a strike. McDade, Patterson, and Jackson will bat in the fifth inning for Lancaster. Home half of this frame. And something is going to have to break soon. To Scott, 0-1, swing and a miss again. Denick well ahead at no balls and two strikes. Ryan Denick, 0-2. Scott lays off. Ball one is in the dirt. One ball and two strikes. We talked to Rich Rundles on the dugout report today about the bullpen and how it's nice to have Andrelzik back. I'm not going to say at full strength, but seems very close to it. The breaking stuff was exceptional last night. Here's a 1-2. Pop fly out the left, pretty shallow. Whitaker coming on, he is there, and he'll take it for the final out. But just to complete that thought, Denick is coming around. Mike Lee has been great lately. Matt Reynolds has been pitching well. Corey Burns, terrific, especially here at home. Scott Gracie is Scott Gracie. And there are others. No runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. We'll go to the bottom half of the fifth inning. The Skeeters have the advantage, though, 5-0.
Here we go. It is.
Hi, this is Hall of Famer Carlton Fisk. Make your plans today to visit Cooperstown and the Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum. Reconnect with your memories of the game and make new memories with your family. Check out baseballhall.org today for more information.
Carlton Fisk had a lot of little boy in him right there, Joe.
The National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum, preserving history, honoring excellence, and connecting generations.
The best fast-pitch softball players in the world are back in Lancaster. On June 3rd and 4th, the PA Rebellion will take on the Dallas Charge in National Pro Fast-Pitch regular season games at Clipper Magazine Stadium. Enjoy the rapid-fire action of fast pitch and a great night out with the family. Come out and see stars like former Rookie of the Year Kristen Sandberg, 2015 Defensive Player of the Year Elisa Goller, and newcomer Stacy Porter, dubbed the world's best hitter. Tickets for these two evenings are on sale at the Two Dudes box office. Go online to LancasterBarnstormers.com or call 509-3633 to order yours.
You know, there are places they have the sausage races in Washington, D.C. at Nats Park. They have the running presidents. We have the race among cuts of pork. Barnstormers has been sponsored by the Pennsylvania Pork Producers Council for years, and this is a new twist to it. Outside for a ball, 1-0 on Mike McDade. He flied to center back in the second inning, but we have a sausage, a ham steak, and a pork chop racing the bases here in the middle of the fifth inning. Ball two is inside. McDade works ahead 2-0. Two walks and three strikeouts for Gallagher, and now Mike McDade hits a drive out to right center field. Well back it goes, and the walls will not contain it. First of the year for Mike McDade, and the Barnstormers are on the board here in the fifth inning. Get that bat going, and this lineup is going to be wicked. McDade with the home run, it is 5-1, and that has to feel awfully good for the man from Las Vegas, Nevada. Chase Patterson will step in. Patterson flied out to right field, back in the third. Barnstormers get the first run back, and these walls are very reachable today. Patterson wraps it foul, and DJ wasn't even willing to go down for that one. It was hit too hard. We've mentioned DJ Boston might be the best fielding third base coach in the Atlantic League. outside and low, and Patterson bats at a ball and a strike. I would imagine that Kevin Baez of the Ducks, the former Mets shortstop, would have something to say about that. Fastball is up high. Patterson bats 2-1. Now the Barnstormers would like to see some extra base runners here. There's stirring in the bullpen for Sugarland. Nobody throwing. Ball 3 is upstairs. Patterson doing a nice job laying off here. Gallagher has been, I think, fairly consistently wild high in this game. 3-1 pitch. There's another one, and Patterson will get the walk. Something else building for Lancaster in this home half of the fifth inning. Justin Jackson will get to the plate. Jackson grounded the shortstop Haig back in the third inning. Justin has 4 hits, 3 of them in the same game against Southern Maryland. Chase Patterson, the runner at first base. Gallagher will work to the plate. And the fastball is good for a strike on Jackson. It is 0-1. He moved over to second base a few innings ago. Logan Schaefer waiting in the on-deck circle. Jackson bats 0-1. Gallagher to the plate. That's right straight through for a second strike, 0-2. High set. Gallagher's pitch is upstairs. Ball 1-2 strikes. Barnstormers have 3 hits in 4-plus innings. And they've also picked up 3 bases on balls. 6 base runners in the game. They can't get anything to stick together very well. Jackson lets it go, and so does Travis Scott. The ball to the backstop, and Patterson will head to second base. My guess is that that one is a wild pitch. We'll check in on the Bill Hoffman official ruling. Breaks up the double play possibilities. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Patterson at second, and a Jackson swing and a miss. He has gone on strikes. 4th for Gallagher, the second he has gotten with a runner in scoring position. Now, Patterson at second base and 1 out. Here is Logan Schaefer. The high set by Gallagher, first pitch. Fastball runs outside, ball 1. The on-deck batter is Kevin Ahrens. A wild pitch. In fact, the ruling that enabled Patterson to get the second base. Schaefer trying to pick up a second run here in the bottom of the fifth. Swing, and that ball is lined to right field down the line, headed for the corner, and this should do it. LaMonta picks it up. He's going to fire into second base. Sliding in with a double is Logan Schaefer. He has brought the Barnstormers within 3 on an RBI double. Patterson loping around to score. Schaefer with a 9-game hitting streak. And here is Kevin Ahrens. He'll look to pick up one more. Ahrens singled into left field back in the 4th inning. A home run by McDade, a double by Schaefer. Here in the 5th inning, the left-handed batter starting to get to Sean Gallagher. To Ahrens. Hit in the air toward right center field. Galloping over on it is Tassoni. He'll make the catch, and Schaefer is not going to try to advance. Ahrens goes after the first pitch from Sean Gallagher here. Hits it well, but not well enough. Caleb Gindel into the batter's box. Gindel has hit a squibber back toward the mound, and he has walked 0-for-1 in the game. Gallagher has handled the on-deck hitter Josh Whitaker fairly well today. But still, they're not going to, I wouldn't think, work around Gindel and bring the tying run to the plate, a guy who has a lot of extra base hits. To Caleb, inside and low. Scott gobbles this one up. Ball one and no strikes. Barnstormers with a pair on the board. They're in the game, very much so. But they could always use another. One ball, no strikes to Caleb Gindel. Gallagher comes back and locates the outer edge. Ball one and strike one. Sugarland is sticking with Gallagher. Nobody throwing in the pen. Hoping this is a bump in the road for their right-hander. To Gindel, 1-1, ground ball on the first base side, taken to the backhand by Scott. He'll head to the bag, and that will do it for the Barnstormers in the fifth, but a productive inning. Lancaster picking up two runs on two hits, no errors. They leave one, and at the end of five today here at Clipper Magazine Stadium, it's Sugarland at now 5 and the Barnstormers 2.
Our congratulations to E.J. Kozlowski of Microsoft.
Two of rock's most iconic names join forces. Leonard Skinner. Peter Frampton. Together in concert. June 8th, Clipper Magazine Stadium. Playing all the hits. Tickets on sale now at amtshows.com, 800-648-4102, or at the AMT box office. Presented by AMT Concerts.
A nice patch of grass, a sloping hillside, and a ball game. Is there any better way to spend your weekend? Well, thanks to Wise Markets and the Lancaster Barnstormers, you can do just that with the Grass Pass package, back this year by popular demand. For only $15, you get a lawn ticket, a delicious Hatfield hot dog, chips, and a fountain soda, plus an exclusive limited edition Barnstormers fleece blanket. Just stop by any participating Wise Market location to purchase your Grass Pass package.
Ryan Denick stays out for a second inning. He'll face Kent Mathis, Johan Lamonta, and Patrick Palmero. It is 5-2 in favor of the Sugarland Skeeters. The Barnstormers made a partial trip back in that bottom of the fifth inning. Mathis will lead off. He has twice flied out today, once to center and once to left. Breaking ball from Denick, good for a strike call to the 0-1. Really like seeing the improvements in Ryan Denick from those first two or three efforts here. He has found some kind of a rhythm. Foul back by Mathis. Denick gets ahead, hit no balls and two strikes. On the Major League scoreboard today, Washington is up over the St. Louis Cardinals. That is 3-1, bottom half of the sixth inning. Here comes the 0-2 pitch, and Mathis floats a liner to Jackson at second, a couple steps to his right, and Justin hauls it in. One man down here in the sixth inning. Johan Lamonta will step in. Lamonta's 0-2. Milwaukee has taken a 3-2 lead over Cincinnati in the bottom of the fourth inning. Phillies trail at Chicago 5-0. Well, don't feel too bad about that. Everybody's being beaten by the Cubs. To Lamonta, first pitch, fastball strike. It is 0-1. The Cubs have a great team and a very, I think, unheralded manager in Joe Maddon. I think that guy eventually could go to the Hall of Fame, especially if he wins a World Series with the Cubs. That in itself should be worthy. Ball is outside and low, 1-1 on Lamonta. I knew Joe back in the 80s. He managed an opposing ball club in the Midwest League. Slow two hopper to shortstop. Aarons will fire on. Lamonta's retired. That's two outs. And Palmero will step in. And just as classy of a guy as you would ever want to meet. and he's got himself a club at Wrigley. San Francisco at Colorado, San Diego at Arizona, Miami at Atlanta, a late afternoon game. And tonight on national cable, the Dodgers and the Mets. Palmeiro stands in, two outs, bases clear in the sixth inning here. Denick will deliver upstairs. Ball one, no strikes on Palmeiro. Patrick is one out of two. Boston 3, Toronto 2, that's in the seventh inning. Jose Bautista with his 11th home run. Baltimore up by one over Cleveland 5-4, bottom seven. Indians started today in first place in the AL Central. Ground ball left side and through, past Bell. Palmeiro with his second hit of the day, a total of seven for the Skeeters. And with two outs, Wilfredo Rodriguez will come to the plate. Yankees are up 2-1 over Tampa Bay. That is in the eighth inning. Kansas City 2 and the White Sox 1. They're in the bottom half of the fourth. Pirates ahead of Texas 1-0 in the second inning. Houston at the Angels, Detroit at Oakland, and Minnesota at Seattle, all to come up later on today. 5-2, Sugarland here. We're in the sixth inning, two outs. Patrick Palmeiro, the runner at first base, and the pitch driven to right by Rodriguez, and Gindel will have to play this off the scoreboard. It'll be a long single. Sprinting toward third is Palmeiro, and he will make it without a throw. So Wilfredo Rodriguez, two swings in a row, has launched a ball to the outfield walls. He didn't have enough height on this, and Gindel played it perfectly. First and third with two gone, and Rick Haig to the plate. The numbers 8 and 9 hitters with the singles against Ryan Denick. This is an important out. You need to put a zero on the board after your team has just scored to keep the momentum on your side. Palmeiro up the line from third. Rodriguez off first base. A swing and a miss by Haig. He is down 0-1. Ryan Denick, one of many pitchers on the Barnstormers, sporting a full beard, not just missing shaving for 5 or 6 days, but we're talking about the full bushy beard. 0-1, there's a bunt by Haig and a good one. Tricky play. Patterson will hold on to the baseball, but the runner at third, Palmeiro, was not able to score on it. So this will bring on Brooks Conrad with the bases loaded and two outs. A bunt single for Haig, but when you've got a runner at third in a situation like that, it's almost a waste if he's not tipped off. But where that bunt was, it would have been more likely for Patterson to be able to tag Palmeiro than to throw out Haig, and that's really what Chase was looking for, was a tag on Palmeiro, and he almost had that where is he reaction. Oh, he's still at third base. Swing and a miss at a fastball, and it is 0-1. So a base hit with a runner at third, and it doesn't score him. How bizarre. Conrad bats 0-1. Denick is inside with his next delivery. Ball one, strike one, and what a crucial out here. Meanwhile, action for the Barnstormers in the bullpen. Looks like Mark Lamb throwing. The first two outs came quickly here. Palmeiro with the ground single through the left side. Rodriguez a single off the scoreboard. Haig the bunt hit to Conrad, 1-1, and Denick misses outside and falls behind in the count 2-1. Brooks Conrad with an infield single in the fifth inning against Denick, and he walked in the third. Conrad will be looking for something that he likes a whole heck of a lot. Two outs, bases loaded. So Denick has to come to him. Two balls and a strike, swing and a miss. 2-2. It would be a big escape for Denick to get out of this inning. Whitaker, Bell, and Halton scheduled in the bottom of the sixth. Here is the 2-2 outside. Something has to give. 3-2, two outs, bases loaded. Up until the Palmeiro single, Denick had retired five straight. Can't get the third out here in the sixth inning. Payoff pitch to Conrad. Swung on, foul tipped and held by Patterson. Huge strikeout for Ryan Denick. Sugarland frozen at five, no runs, three hits, no errors, three men left on base. We will go to the bottom half of the sixth inning with the score, Sugarland 5, Lancaster 2.
A nice patch of grass, a sloping hillside, and a ball game. Is there any better way to spend your weekend? Well, thanks to Wise Markets and the Lancaster Barnstormers, you can do just that with the Grass Pass package, back this year by popular demand. For only $15, you get a lawn ticket, a delicious Hatfield hot dog, chips, and a fountain soda, plus an exclusive limited edition Barnstormers fleece blanket. Just stop by any participating Wise Market location to purchase your Grass Pass package.
It's baseball season, and no one is more excited about that than we here at Lancaster Bible College, proud sponsor of Lancaster Barnstormers Baseball. At Lancaster Bible College, you can earn your associate's, bachelor's, master's, seminary, or doctoral degrees through a distinctly biblical lens in areas like leadership, communication, business administration, social work, education, pastoral studies, music, and many more. Find out how you can take the next step in your educational journey to earn a degree from LBC. Visit us on the web at lbc.edu. We look forward to seeing you at Barnstormers Games this season.
Josh Whitaker leads off the sixth inning. He is 0 for 2. Gallagher into the motion, and he delivers outside. Ball one, no strikes. So the momentum should still be on the Barnstormers' side right now. See what Whitaker can do to get the ball club started. Line drive, base hit, left field. That's how. Josh Whitaker, a leadoff single here in the sixth inning. Five hits off of Gallagher, and the Sugarland bullpen goes into alert. Josh Bell to the plate. Bell has struck out and grounded 3-1. This guy can do some awfully exciting things. Andrew Johnston, very difficult right-hander, begins to loosen up in the Sugarland pen. To Bell, it is upstairs, ball one. Sean Halton waits on deck. Sugarland had a 5-0 lead through three innings. Lancaster whittled away with two last frame. Whitaker aboard to start the sixth. Bell takes a strike on the outer edge. It is 1-1. Barnstormers bench now is down to Charlie Cutler and Travis Witherspoon today. Kevin Aaron's already been utilized. Ball two is low on Bell, 2-1. Jeff Coburnus came out of the game after the first couple of innings, and my suspicion is that it had something to do with the steal attempt in the first inning, but we don't have any confirmation of that. And it could very well be some other reason. Swing and a foul tip by Bell, 2-2 to the Barnstormer third baseman. Trying to advance a sixth inning rally. Lancaster now has Al Yavoli warming up in the bullpen. DeSoni and Scott would be among the three batters scheduled in the seventh. They're lefties. Ground ball, shortstop. This could be two. The feed to second for one. Conrad back to first. They double up Bell. 6-4-3. And that takes a little bit of steam out of this inning. Sean Halton will step in. Halton is 0-for-1 with a base on balls today. Two outs, base is clear. Barnstormers trying to climb back in. They've got Johnston and they've got Loop in that bullpen, and they are awfully difficult to get to. No earned runs against either one all season. They've only lost one game, talking about the Skeeters, where they have led after six. Check swing, ground ball on the first base side. Hustling over to cover the bag is Gallagher. He'll accept the toss from Scott. No runs on a hit, no errors, nobody left. Promising start to the sixth inning, but nothing ever developed. We're on our way to the seventh. It is Sugarland 5, Lancaster 2.
Hey kids, thanks to Isaac's, you can be part of the Barnstormers. The Isaac's Barnyard Bunch is quite a deal. You get lawn vouchers for six games, six kids park passes, the chance to go on the field with your Barnstormers during the national anthem on two different nights, and a Barnyard Bunch t-shirt. But there's more. Any Barnyard Bunch member will get two vouchers for kids meals at your favorite Lancaster County Isaac's Deli. You get all of this for only $25. Even better, if you sign up at your local Isaac's, you save $5 more. So join the Barnyard Bunch today.
What's more fun and exciting than playing Pennsylvania Millions with top prizes of $1 million? Winning on the spot.
Woohoo! I won!
So if you can't wait to win, then don't wait to play. Pennsylvania Millions from the Pennsylvania Lottery for a chance to win up to $1 million on the spot. The Pennsylvania Lottery. Keep on scratching. Players must be 18 or older. Please play responsibly. Benefits older Pennsylvanians every day.
Five runs on nine hits, error-free baseball for the Sugarland Skeeters, and Sugarland is stranded six. The Barnstormers have two runs on five hits and an error with four men left on base. Rene Tassoni digging in to lead off against Yavoli. Tassoni today is 0-3 for Yavoli. A couple of losses on the year. His ERA has begun to drop. It started very high this season. Breaking ball is low on Tassoni, 1-0. And Sugarland, one of the main reasons. Scott got to him for the grand slam in extra innings back in Texas. Tassoni tries to hold on the swing, and he does, a pitch in the dirt. Yavoli works two balls and no strikes. Now to Tassoni. Adele's gone the last six innings without giving up a run. Last pitched Wednesday against New Britain. Ball three is inside and low. Three balls and nothing. Ryan Denick worked two innings. He gave up four hits, all singles, struck out two, no runs. Here's the 3-0 pitch. Ball four is low, and Yavoli wasn't really close on any of those four pitches. Third walk given up by Lancaster pitching in the game. And here is Jeremy Barfield, who has singled, walked, and grounded out. 1-for-2. He has scored a run. So once again, Yavoli allows the first batter he faces to reach base. Fastball good for a strike here on Barfield. It is 0-1. That's 8 of 12 this year that have gotten on against Al to start off his work, whether that's starting an inning or not. The pitch misses a little bit down low, I suppose. And one ball, one strike count to Barfield. He's checking down to Gary Gaetti to see what may be up with Tassoni, who's one of the few on this team who tends to run. He's going to stay put. Barfield swing and a foul tip. One ball and two strikes. Uvoli, remember last year, retired the first batter he faced, 21 of 23 games. It was exceptional. The set, the look over toward Tassoni, and now to the plate, swung on and missed. Nasty off-speed pitch. Barfield is gone on strikes. One out with the runner at first base, and now a rematch against Travis Scott. Scott was awarded the Grand Slam. We talked about this earlier. Uvoli was the pitcher in question. And the Barnstormers never had really the opportunity to argue. Sugarland kept circling the bases. The umpires apparently signaled home run. The ball stayed in the ballpark from what I've been told. Ball one is inside and low on Scott, 1-0. Though there was no question about the home run he hit in the third inning. I saw that with my own eyes. Ball was hit toward the chain link fence in front of the visitor's bullpen at Constellation Field. Ball is loose in left field. I don't know if anybody sees it out there except for Josh Whitaker. The pitch headed home, and we get a foul out of play, and that's a good thing. None of the umpires saw it. Whitaker did and went to chase it out of there and then realized that Uvoli was about to pitch, and Whitaker said, well, I'd better leave it there and hope the ball isn't hit to my right, because I'd hate to somehow slip and fall on the other one. There goes Tassoni. The pitch is inside, and Patterson can't even throw. That's a stolen base for Tassoni. He is 4-for-4. He stole that off of Uvoli's first move. Travis Scott working with a count of 2-1. Against the left-hander Uvoli, Kent Mathis waits on deck. Lancaster down by 3 here in the seventh inning. Uvoli glancing back to Sony. Has him distracted, and eventually Travis Scott grows impatient. Gets the timeout at home plate.
Right here, Court.
Silo on top of the third base dugout. He looks hot out there today. Scott fouls another away. 2-2 to the lefty batting first baseman. We saw Scott catch last night. He was the DH in the series opener. Gary Gaetti has a lot of moving parts in his ball club. He has a mix and match lineup with a great amount of versatility. Barnstormers, with the exception of Justin Jackson, don't necessarily have that, though Halton can play all four corners. Uvoli bluffing the runner to Sony back to second base. Travis Scott batting 2-2. To Sony, not going. The pitch is high to Scott. He lays off. It is ball 3 and 2 strikes. Nobody else throwing in the Barnstormers bullpen, so Uvoli has to work his way out of this. The Barnstormers down 3 runs, and it looks like they're going to experience the Sugarland bullpen once we get to the bottom half of this inning. Payoff pitch to Scott, stroked on the right side. Jackson with the pickup, lob throw to first, 2 outs. But Tassoni motors ahead to third, and Kent Mathis will try to pick him up. Mathis is 0-for-3.
Left fielder Kent Mathis, your Schwager brothers, K-man of the game.
He had an infield single last night, which was the only base runner allowed by Pete Andrelzik an inning in 2/3. Tassoni at third base with 2 outs. Fielders well back here, and to Mathis. Uvoli is low, ball 1. You do have a left-handed batter on deck in Johan Lamonta. Meanwhile, Johnston continues to throw in the Sugarland pen. Fastball for a strike, it is 1-1. And he has been the right-handed setup ace. Sugarland wants this game after dropping the first 2 of this series. The Barnstormers have a 4-1 edge in the season series, and another win here today would give them a tie for the tiebreaker. Ground ball right side. Uvoli has pitched his way out of the inning. Jackson with the short throw. Mathis is done. So is Sugarland here in the top half of the seventh inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one man left on base. We're at the stretch here at Clipper Magazine Stadium. The score, Sugarland 5, Lancaster 2.
Top-level soccer is returning to Clipper Magazine Stadium. Enjoy the world's game at Lancaster's premier family entertainment facility through the spring and summer seasons. Come see the City Islanders Football Club take on United Soccer League rivals the Richmond Kickers on Friday, July 8th. Two nights later, the City Islanders will look to defend their home pitch in Lancaster from a second invasion of the Toronto Football Club. Tickets for these two events are available through the Two Dudes box office by calling 717-509-HITS or by going online to LancasterBarnstormers.com. Don't miss out on these special events.
The National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown is the place where baseball legends live forever. It's where the exciting moments of today stand along the iconic tales of the past. With new exhibits and artifacts telling incredible stories, the Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum is a must-see destination for fans of all ages. Baseball in Cooperstown. Oh, my. Plan your visit today. Check out baseballhall.org.
Andrew Johnston has taken over here in the seventh inning for the Sugarland Skeeters. Sean Gallagher went six. He gave up five hits, two runs. They were both earned. Walked three, struck out four, and was charged with a wild pitch. McDade, Patterson, and Jackson to face Johnston, who has been almost perfect this season. 6 foot 5 inch right-hander. The wind, the pitch, and McDade, who homered the last time around, looks at a strike. It is 0-1. Johnston brings it home. McDade lays off, and the next pitch drifts outside. Ball one and strike one. Andrew Johnston for the season has given up one unearned run, but he's allowed only 11 hits and one walk in 19 and two-thirds innings. He's got two wins and a save. McDade looks at strike two on the outside corner. One ball, two strikes. We saw Johnston here Friday night, and he threw a perfect inning in a third, retiring 4 of 4, one strikeout. To McDade, the 1-2 is on the way. Mike with a chopper to first base, foul by the time it reaches Travis Scott. Mike still in there with a count of one ball and two strikes. It's got to be nice to know you've got Andrew Johnston and Luke up. When you're a starting pitcher, you give the quality start and come out with a lead. That lead is great. The McDade 1-2, he holds on the swing, and ball two is just past the outside corner. Appeal down to Dave Speranza. He says no. Lancaster has been out hit 9-5 today, outscored 5-2. Gallagher into the motion, the pitch, and a golf swing pops it up on the right side. Brooks Conrad on the edge of the outfield grass reaches back at the last second to make the catch. McDade is gone, one away. That'll bring on Chase Patterson. He has flied out, walked, and scored a run. Lamb warming up in the Lancaster bullpen, and nobody actually throwing on the Sugarland side. One guy moving around down there. To Patterson, ground ball to third. Nice backhanded stop by Palmeiro, and Patterson is cut down 5-3. It wouldn't have been a great play except for the fact that Palmeiro was playing up at the edge of the infield grass. And that ball was on him quickly. And he just paralyzed it with the glove. Cutting down Patterson with the throw. Two outs, Justin Jackson the batter. JJ 0 for 2. He is grounded out. He is struck out. The Johnston pitch fired low. Ball one, no strikes. Big play of the game. Travis Scott's three-run home run to straightaway right field back in the third inning. That made it 5-0. The Barnstormers able to claw back partially in the fifth, but they need more. Driven down the right field line by Jackson, slicing toward the corner and just foul. Justin Jackson almost extra bases, but instead he'll have to catch hold of another delivery from Andrew Johnston. One ball and one strike to Jackson. Logan Schaefer, Lancaster center fielder, waits on deck. And they do have a little bit more action. Right-hander again throwing for Sugarland. First pitch, or not first pitch, but a second strike on Jackson. It is 1-2. That is Zek Zinicola. We saw him on Friday as well. Jackson bats 1-2. Stop made by Rodriguez on a pitch low. Two balls and two strikes. The home runs in the third inning are what hurt starter Tanner Peters today. Here's a 2-2 Jackson with a swing and a miss against a nasty breaking ball. Johnston retires the side in order in the seventh inning and will go to the eighth with the Sugarland Skeeters up 5-2.
LocalFlavor.com, local flavor. LocalFlavor.com, local flavor.
Excuse me, are you saying LocalFlavor.com?
Oh, yeah, it's where I save big bucks on all kinds of things. Home improvement projects, dining out, family fun, electronics, jewelry, clothing. I even bought my wife a fancy spa package for half price.
Half price?
Yep, you know all the deals you find in Clipper Magazine.
I love Clipper Magazine.
Well, they're all on LocalFlavor.com, too. And you can get them right on your phone, thanks to LocalFlavor.com's mobile app. Here, take a look.
Well, this app is amazing. Look at all these restaurants, amusement parks, car washes, fitness centers. This is worth sharing about.
Exactly. LocalFlavor.com online, the Local Flavor mobile app, and Clipper Magazine together. It's like a triple play.
Do the cheer again. I'm in.
LocalFlavor.com, Local Flavor. Come on, everybody! LocalFlavor.com, local flavor. LocalFlavor.com, local flavor.
Right-handed sidewheeler Mark Lamb gets to work the eighth inning. He pitched the ninth last night. It got off to a rocky start, then retired three in a row. To face LaMonta, Palmeiro, and Rodriguez here. Al Yavoli worked the seventh and following a leadoff walk, retired the side in order. Though the runner ended up at third base on a steal and a ground out. Lamb on here for the eighth. The Barnstormers are still lurking around. And it appears they'll get Zinicola next. And after that, if it's still 5-2, they get Derek Loop. One-time Barnstormer is dominant out of the Sugarland bullpen. He's given up one earned run in his last 38 appearances. Here's LaMonta, he's 0 for 3. Lamb's first pitch turns back away. Ball one, no strikes. In the current series, LaMonta has one hit. That was a triple to right center field last night. Here's a 1-0 in the air, left field, straight away. Josh Whitaker didn't have to move. He did. He came in a step or two and then went back a step or two. The movement negated each other. One out. Patrick Palmeiro to the plate. He is 2 for 3. He got signed during the winter. Didn't make the club or a club in an organization out of spring training and ended up back in Sugarland. outside and low. Ball one, one of this league's better defensive third basemen, not hitting quite as productively as he did last year. But you can't necessarily tell that by this series. Ball one, no strikes. Lamb gets him to chase the sidearm breaking ball. It is 1-1. Motion, and Palmeiro swings and misses again on a pitch that got away from Chase Patterson. One ball and two strikes. 320 to left, 400 to center, 300 down the right field line. And most of the fans here today, we've got a crowd of 30-61. They're huddled up under the overhang. One ball, two strikes. Lamb to Palmeiro, he lays off, he did not go, says the appeal to first base and John Harrington. 2-2. Silo upset about that last call. Calm down, Silo, before you get tossed out of here. Maybe that's what you want. It's hot in that, all that fur. Outside, ball three. Palmeiro batting at 3-2. One out, bases clear, top half of the eighth inning. Lazy Sunday afternoon at the ballpark on Memorial Day weekend. Ball four is low, Lamb loses Palmeiro. One out, one on. Here is Wilfredo Rodriguez. He's had some kind of a day. Two hits, including his first Atlantic League home run. His blast made it 2-0 back in the third inning. First run scored on a wild pitch, and then there were the home runs accounting for the four runs in the third. Sugarland has not scored since. The Barnstormers have had a couple of cracks to try and get back in this game. Strike called, 0-1 on Rodriguez. But Lancaster has grounded into a double play. The runner was thrown out stealing. And the club is 1-for-7 with runners in scoring position. So not taking full advantage of the chances. Ball one is inside. Ricky Haig, the shortstop, waits on deck. The home run for the Barnstormers today, solo. Lamb deals, ground ball back to the mound. Lamb spears it to short for one, back to first, and they double up Rodriguez, 1-6-3. It would have actually been easier if Mark had let that one go, but he gets the double play started anyhow. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth inning. Still 5-2 Sugarland.
We at Gockenauer Appliance know that buying a major appliance for your home is a major and tough decision. We want you to make that process easier. We now have a new website at gockenauers.com that you can view live inventory, spec sheets, and all of our closeout and scratch and dent inventory. Browse the site and either purchase online or stop into our store and see the models in our huge showroom. Remember, we still offer the best brands at the best prices and back it up with the best service around. Gockenauer's in East Petersburg and now online.
The best fast-pitch softball players in the world are back in Lancaster. On June 3rd and 4th, the PA Rebellion will take on the Dallas Charge in National Pro Fast-Pitch regular season games at Clipper Magazine Stadium. Enjoy the rapid-fire action of fast-pitch and a great night out with the family. Come out and see stars like former Rookie of the Year Kristen Sandberg, 2015 Defensive Player of the Year Elisa Goller, and newcomer Stacy Porter, dubbed the world's best hitter. Tickets for these two evenings are on sale at the Two Dudes box office. Go online to LancasterBarnstormers.com or call 509-3633 to order yours.
Andrew Johnston pitched a 1-2-3 seventh inning. Zach Zinicola takes over for the eighth. He gets the top of the order. Schaefer, Ahrens, and Gindel, with Whitaker in the hole, and already Derek Loop is warming up in the bullpen. We mentioned how good of a closer Loop has been for this Sugarland ball club. Barnstormers looking to get to Zinicola. He retired the side in the order in the eighth inning Friday night, facing Halton, McDade, and Cutler. Logan Schaefer, the batter, is hitting streak intact at 9 games with an RBI double into the right field corner back in the fifth inning. He's a very steady player, is Schaefer. Barnstormers down by 3. Schaefer takes a strike at the knees. It is 0-1. Lancaster got its 2 runs in the fifth inning. A home run, a walk, and a double. A wild pitch was involved. Nothing in one. Schaefer, a soft liner over the head of the leaping Brooks Conrad, and a base hit. One man on here in the eighth inning, and the tying run moves to the on-deck circle for Lancaster. Schaefer didn't hit that terribly well. The ball kept us in suspense for a moment. Conrad tried to time his leap and came up a bit short. Schaefer aboard with the single. Kevin Ahrens the batter. Ahrens is 1 out of 2. Down by 3. You have to just keep swinging away. You can't play for 1 run here. Zinicola to Ahrens. Kevin takes a strike. Looked like maybe a cutter there. Too slow for that, I suppose. Slider, perhaps. Nothing in 1 on Kevin Ahrens. Palmeiro is playing up against the bunt. Schaefer leads from first base. Zinicola glances over his shoulder. Now the pitch to the plate. That's outside. Gets away from Rodriguez. And moving on to second is Logan Schaefer. Once again, we have to check in on the decision of official scorer Bill Hoffman. One ball, one strike. We don't have that decision as of yet. My thinking is pass ball on that one, but I'm maybe a little more pitcher friendly than others. It was to the backhanded side of Scott, but not that far of a reach. Lancaster moving a runner to second base. That pass ball is, in fact, the ruling. Here's a 1-1. Aaron swings and misses. Zinicola's got him at 1-2. Barnstormers trying to get within 2. A base hit would get the heart of the order and all that natural home run power up with the tying run at the plate. And that presents an opportunity. Ahrens bats 1-2, Zinicola to the plate, and Kevin beats it to third. Up with it on a short hop is Palmeiro. He will get Ahrens. 5-3 on the out, 1 away. Caleb Gindel will step in. Down by 3 in the eighth inning, you don't worry as much about getting the runner to third base. That certainly didn't accomplish it, but not as critical right now as it would be in a 1-run game. Caleb Gindel stepping in. 0-2 with a walk on the day for him. Zinicola to the plate, and Gindel looks at a strike on the outside corner. 0-1 as he got a fastball from Zach Zinicola. On deck, the left fielder, Josh Whitaker. Schaefer leading from second. Zinicola to the set, and to Gindel up and away. Ball 1, strike 1. Witherspoon and Cutler available off the bench. And I'm not sure you'll see a situation in this game where either one would be brought in, unless you're facing maybe a right-hander in the ninth inning. They bat Cutler for Patterson. Caleb Gindel batting 1-1. Zinicola to the plate, drops it low, and advantage Gindel. 2 balls and a strike. Believe me, Zinicola wants the out here because you don't want anybody in the middle of the Lancaster batting order stepping in as the potential tying run. Two Two balls, one strike. The right-hander ready to go. Gindel gets ball three upstairs. Well, the Barnstormers may have that chance to tie the game. There is action in the Lancaster bullpen. Josh Wall throwing. Schaefer leads from second. It is 3-1 to Gindel. Zinicola misses outside, and the tying run comes to the batter's box. Fourth walk picked up by Lancaster pitching on the afternoon to go along with six hits. Big at bat for Josh Whitaker. He's 1-for-3 on the day, batting with Schaefer at second, Gindel at first. You don't need to get it all back with one swing. The Skeeters go into the no doubles. Here comes the pitch to Whitaker. Swing, and it's lobbed toward the right side. This is playable, though. LaMonta is there for the catch, and out number two with Josh Bell stepping in. Another day where the Barnstormers can't get that big hit. 1-for-9 with runners in scoring position. And if you totaled up the numbers in the Barnstormers' losses this season, that is what seems lagging. Gary Gaetti is coming out to the mound. He does not want Bell facing Zinicola. He's going to go to loop for a possible four-out save here and turn Bell around to bat from the right side. That's why he had Derek Loop warming up all along. He was looking ahead to this potential matchup. Bell will come to the plate as the tying run, but he'll do so right-handed as Loop comes in, and we're going to take a break and pause for these words from our sponsors.
A nice patch of grass, a sloping hillside, and a ball game. Is there any better way to spend your weekend? Well, thanks to Wise Markets and the Lancaster Barnstormers, you can do just that with the Grass Pass package, back this year by popular demand. For only $15, you get a lawn ticket, a delicious Hatfield hot dog, chips, and a fountain soda, plus an exclusive limited edition Barnstormers fleece blanket. Just stop by any participating Wise Market location to purchase your Grass Pass package.
Once again, thank you, Lancaster. With your support, we are once again the number one dealer in our district, according to a recent Mitsubishi report. Hi, this is Richard Bennett, co-owner of Lancaster Mitsubishi. To continue our success through the month of May, Ally Financial is offering 0% financing for up to 72 months on select models. And don't forget, with over 25 different lenders and rebates and incentives from Mitsubishi, we can put you into a brand new car with absolutely zero money down. And if you purchase a vehicle from us in the month of May, Lancaster Mitsubishi has partnered with the Lancaster Barnstormers to give you tickets to the Lancaster Mitsubishi Suite. So, Lancaster, make your way to Lancaster Mitsubishi and become part of our story. As always, all sales come with our famous LLM Club, Lifetime State Safety Inspections and Car Washes as long as you own the vehicle. We are located on the corner of McGovern Avenue and North Prince Street next to the train station. You know we have what you deserve.
Derek Loop comes on with the tying run scheduled to come to the plate. Two outs here in the lower half of the eighth inning. Loop has been just about invincible this year in 13 and two-thirds innings. He's allowed 11 hits. He has walked four, struck out 13, no runs. He's only given up one earned run in his last 38 appearances as a Skeeter dating back to July of last season. And the move to Loop not only gets a great closer on the mound, but it forces Josh Bell to bat right-handed in this ballpark. It's not anything against Bell batting right-handed. It's just this ballpark, which favors the lefties. Two on, two out. Loop into the motion, and to Bell. High hopper to the shortstop. Taken by Haig. He'll get the force out of Caleb Gindel at second. On one pitch, Derek Loop gets the Skeeters out of the eighth. And the Barnstormers will have to reload in the ninth inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, two men left on. We're on our way to the ninth inning of baseball. It is Sugarland 5 and the Barnstormers 2.
It's baseball season, and no one is more excited about that than we here at Lancaster Bible College, proud sponsor of Lancaster Barnstormers Baseball. At Lancaster Bible College, you can earn your associate's, bachelor's, master's, seminary, or doctoral degrees through a distinctly biblical lens in areas like leadership, communication, business administration, social work, education, pastoral studies, music, and many more. Find out how you can take the next step in your educational journey to earn a degree from LBC. Visit us on the web at lbc.edu. We look forward to seeing you at Barnstormers games this season.
Two of rock's most iconic names join forces. Lynyrd Skynyrd. Peter Frampton. Together in concert. June 8th, Clipper Magazine Stadium. Playing all the hits. Tickets on sale now at amtshows.com, 800-648-4102, or at the AMT box office. Presented by AMT Concerts.
Josh Wall gets the ninth inning. The Barnstormers bullpen has thrown four scoreless frames so far, keeping Lancaster at least in the neighborhood. Ricky Hague will lead off the ninth against Wall. Get the impression, without asking Josh directly, but I overheard a conversation with him and Rich Rundle's days, just trying to tweak a couple of things here. 11th appearance as a Barnstormer, and Mr. Wall can be very, very good. Ball one and no strikes, he's really hard to hit. And his control has been somewhat sporadic. He's got vicious stuff. Here is the 1-0. And the fastball is on the outside corner to Hague. It is 1-1. Hague got Sugarland underway right off the bat today. A double leading off against Tanner Peters. He would eventually score on a wild pitch in that first inning. Wall ready to go. Here's the 1-1. And this is driven foul to the right side. A second strike on Rick Hague. It is 1-2. Denick worked two innings. Yavoli and Lamb have gone one each. And Wall gets the ninth. Josh pitched two-thirds of an inning here on Friday. Walked one, but got his fourth hold. One ball, two strikes to Hague. Josh ready to go. The pitch bends downward. Hague laid off, two balls and two strikes. It's got to be tough to lay off that pitch, I would think. A four-run third inning, the difference in the ball game, specifically the three-run homer by Travis Scott in that inning. Two balls, two strikes. Wall brings it home. This is chopped the short. Second bounce played by Aaron's long throw, and Hague is cut down 6-3. One retired, Brooks Conrad will come to the plate, 1-for-3 with a run scored. That was following a walk, that run scored in the third. He was on when Scott hit that home run. Lancaster has Halton, McDade, and Patterson due in the ninth inning against Derek Loop. You've got Witherspoon. He could run. You could see him pinch hit somewhere, I suppose. You really don't have many moves left. Fastball is up and away. Ball one on Conrad. It is 1-0. Cutler would be more likely to bat against for Patterson against a right-hander. Swing and a miss. 1-1. Wall just has such natural, terrific downward movement. Here's a 1-1 inside and low to Conrad. Two balls and a strike. We talked about the one flaw has been his tendency to throw a lot of pitches in the dirt into the left side batter's box, or certainly low all the way around. To Conrad, 2-1, and it is inside, three balls and a strike. The walk has definitely been the issue for Josh Wall. He's given up seven hits in 9 2/3 innings, but also seven walks. Three balls, one strike. The Brooks Conrad wall ready to go. He is outside with a fastball, and he walks Conrad. One out, one on. Rene Tassoni will come to the plate.
Center fielder Rene Tassoni.
Wall has done a decent job, but I have a feeling that somewhere in there is a man who could be completely dominant here. Conrad leads off first, not going anywhere, and the ball is bounded foul by Tassoni. It is 0-1. Of course, I suppose everybody who's a fan, a broadcaster, a coach, or a member of any ball club feels that way about his or her own team. That there's more there than what you're seeing, that somehow there's unlocked potential. Conrad takes off. Wall finally realizes it. Throw to Ahrens, and they cut him down. He left way too soon. Josh Wall hadn't committed to the plate. And Brooks Conrad is thrown out stealing. Somebody just had to get Wall's attention out of that focus on the hitter. And that there was still time. It dawned on Josh what they were saying, and he's able to throw out Conrad stealing. Now upstairs on Tassoni, a ball and a strike. One ball, one strike. Partial swing, and Tassoni can't fish it out. It's one ball and two strikes. And to me, watching Wall, he has closer stuff. And that is, of course, important. If Corey Burns should happen to sign, you have to have somebody else take over that role. Reynolds, I would think, could do it, and I think Wall could do it. The pitch is inside and low, and it hits Tassoni in the ankle. Well, the Barnstormers have hit a batter now for six straight games. It comes late in this one. Two outs, and Jeremy Barfield the batter. A walk and a hit batter. The last two men stepping in. Wall to Barfield, swing and a miss at the heat. It is 0-1. I really do. I think this guy has closer stuff. I could certainly see him jumping into that role if the need were to arise. No balls and a strike. Wall to the set to Barfield. He is low. Ball one, strike one. Obviously, you'd want him to throw some more strikes. Tassoni already has a stolen base today. He's got a decent-sized lead off first. He's going to go. The pitch is swung at and popped up on the right side of the infield. Who is calling for this one? And finally, it is Bell behind the pitcher's mound, almost to the right side of the pitcher's mound, making the catch. First guy who looked up was Halton, and he started coming in for it, but it really wasn't in his neighborhood. No runs, no hits, no errors. One man left on base. Bottom of the ninth rolls around here at Clipper Magazine Stadium. It is the Sugarland Skeeters 5 and the Lancaster Barnstormers 2.
There are wants, and then there are needs. Two clearly distinctive words that are often used interchangeably, especially in the case of the Lexus NX Turbo. As a luxury crossover, it can provide the utility you need. But with its bold, aggressive styling and a turbocharged engine, you may consider it more of a want. The Lexus NX Turbo. Once you go beyond utility, there's no going back. See Bobby Rahal Lexus in Mechanicsburg.
A last chance for the Lancaster Barnstormers. They need three against one of this league's premier closers, Derek Loop. Sean Halton will try to get it started. Sean today is 0 for 2 with a walk. First time he has been corralled at all by the Sugarland Skeeters. Big series in the works for Halt. Defense plays him straight away. It's 5-2 Sugarland. Here is the motion by Loop and the pitch. Ball one is high on Halton. It is 1-0. Lancaster has had chances. And again, the ball club 1-for-10 with runners in scoring position. Ripped foul, and that makes DJ Boston dance. In the third base coach's box, it is 1-1. DJ leapt over that hot ground ball, kind of doing the splits in the process. Here's a 1-1. Ball two is low to Sean. Two balls and a strike. Loop shares the Barnstormer record for most walks by a pitcher in a game. A couple of others have done it with 8 walks. J.D. Durbin was one of the others. Here comes the 2-1. Halton swings and he belts one out the left field. Mathis going back all the way, back, and the walls will not contain it. Halton with his third home run of the series, one to each field. And it's 5-3. Well, they had him controlled for a little while today, but Halton has absolutely murdered Sugarland pitching, and Derek Loop gives up his first run of 2016. Now, where was that last inning when the tying run was at the plate? McDade and Halton with home runs today, and here is McDade stepping in against Derek Loop. The kick and the pitch. First one over for a strike on Mike. It is 0-1, so it's a 5-3 ball game now. Lancaster trailed 5-0 at one point. Loop comes back 0-1, down low, a ball and a strike. Well, if the Barnstormers catch up here in the bottom half of the ninth inning, someone please come and protect me from Derek Loop, because he's going to accuse me of putting the whammy on him. High pop fly here to center field. Rene Tassoni will come on and make the catch. It's out number one. I was kidding with him the other night. I just walked up to him. I congratulated him on having such a good season going. And he said, oh, now you've done it. I may already be in trouble because of the Halton home run, spoiling Loop's perfect ERA for the year. Chase Patterson comes to the plate. He is 0 for 2 with a walk and a run scored. Well, Derek's a big guy. Somebody may need to hide me. To Patterson, fastball is in there, a strike called. It is 0-1. Lancaster down to a final 2 outs today. Patterson fouls the next offering away. Loop's got him 0-2. Justin Jackson, the on-deck batter. Sugarland ahead by a pair here in the bottom of the ninth. The Barnstormers certainly have done enough here to keep their fans interested. Here's the motion, the 0-2 way off the plate outside. Ball one and two strikes. Fastball high, 2-2. And now outside, ball three, filling the count, 3-2. Tapper foul, Patterson doing a nice job battling Derek Loop here in the ninth inning. And the payoff pitch. Did he go on it? He did, says the first base umpire, John Harrington. Almost a walk, but it ends up being a strikeout, and that is a monumental difference here in the ninth inning. Two outs, bases are clear. Justin Jackson, the final hope for the Barnstormers. Logan Schaefer into the on-deck circle. Sean Halton started off the inning with a home run. Lancaster hasn't been able to get anything else generated. Ball one down low to Jackson, 1-0. Schaefer's on deck. He's had a good series. Jackson takes a strike from Loop. Make it 1-1. Next delivery. Tickles the outside corner. It's 1-2. Loop is just vicious. As long as he's throwing enough strikes, he's awfully tough to get to. 1-2. Jackson keeps us alive. A foul ball to the right and out of play. Still 1-2. Game four of this series will come up tomorrow, also at 2 o'clock. Austin Bibbins-Dirks getting the start for Lancaster. He'll match up against a lefty named Aaron Thompson. We've not seen him before. He's 1-0. To Jackson, outside. 2-2 to the Lancaster second baseman. Next offering, fouled back. Jackson keeps it going. Two balls, two strikes, and holding. The Barnstormers don't have all that many hits in this series. We talked about this earlier. They only have 23 hits. But a slew of extra base hits. Here comes the 2-2. Jackson swings and misses. Ball game over today. Sugarland wins for the first time in the series. One run, one hit, no errors, and nobody left for the Barnstormers here in the bottom half of the ninth inning. We'll be back with the wrap-up show coming your way next. Our final score this afternoon, the Sugarland Skeeters 5 and the Lancaster Barnstormers 3.
Let's welcome back Gus, the second most famous groundhog in Pennsylvania.
Thanks, Glenn.
How was your birthday?
Great. We went to a Mexican restaurant. I played the maracas. It was a real blowout.
Speaking of which, it's about the new blowout instant games from the Pennsylvania Lottery.
You can win $225 million in cash prizes.
Sounds like my kind of party. Thanks again, Gus.
Keep on scratching.
The Pennsylvania Lottery. Players must be 18 or older. Please play responsibly. Benefits older Pennsylvanians every day.
A nice patch of grass, a sloping hillside, and a ball game. Is there any better way to spend your weekend? Well, thanks to Wise Markets and the Lancaster Barnstormers, you can do just that with the Grass Pass package, backed this year by popular demand. For only $15, you get a lawn ticket, a delicious Hatfield hot dog, chips, and a fountain soda, plus an exclusive limited edition Barnstormers fleece blanket. Just stop by any participating Wise Market location to purchase your Grass Pass package.
Barnstormers drop a 5-3 decision here today. They fought back valiantly after dropping behind 5-0 early. Sugarland, 5 runs, 9 hits, no errors, 8 left. Lancaster, 3 runs on 7 hits with 1 error. And the Barnstormers strand 6. The win goes to Sean Gallagher. He levels his record at 3-3. Tanner Peters with the loss. He is now 1-1. Derek Loop the save, his 8th of the season. Each side with a pair of home runs. The difference in the ball game is that one of Sugarland's came with 2 men aboard. That was hit by Travis Scott in the 3rd inning, his 4th home run of the season. Wilfredo Rodriguez led off that inning with his 1st of the year. For the Barnstormers, 2 inning leadoff home runs. Mike McDade, his 1st of the season in the 5th. Sean Halton, not only his third of the season, his third of the weekend in the ninth inning. 2 hours, 32 minutes, the time of the game, and 3,061 on hand to view it here this afternoon at Clipper Magazine Stadium. Sugarland got the lead on a double, a ground out, and a wild pitch in the first inning, and the home run barrage in the third made it a quick 5-0 in favor of the Skeeters. The Barnstormers bullpen was very stingy this afternoon, 5 shutout innings, and it afforded the team the chance to come back in the ballgame. Lancaster got one run on the board on the McDade homer in the fifth inning, and then later that frame, Chase Patterson walked. He went to second on a wild pitch and scored when Logan Schaefer doubled into the right field corner. Lancaster could not score again until Sean Halton's leadoff blast to left field in the ninth. That would be it. Derek Loop slammed the door from there. The Sugarland Skeeters hold on for the 5-3 victory over the Barnstormers here today. We'll have the out-of-town scores coming your way next right here on the Lancaster Barnstormers YouTube channel.
Localflavor.com, local flavor. Localflavor.com, local flavor.
Excuse me, are you saying localflavor.com?
Oh yeah, it's where I save big bucks on all kinds of things. Home improvement projects, dining out, family fun, electronics, jewelry, clothing. I even bought my wife a fancy spa package for half price.
Half price?
Yep, you know all the deals you find in Clipper Magazine.
I love Clipper Magazine.
Well, they're all on localflavor.com too. And you can get them right on your phone thanks to localflavor.com's mobile app. Here, take a look.
Well, this app is amazing. Look at all these restaurants, amusement parks, car washes, fitness centers. This is worth sharing about.
Exactly. Localflavor.com online, the Local Flavor mobile app, and Clipper Magazine together. It's like a triple play.
Do the cheer again. I'm in.
Localflavor.com, local flavor. Come on, everybody. Localflavor.com, local flavor. Localflavor.com, local flavor.
Well, the Barnstormers dropped the 5-3 decision here today. Long Island up big over New Britain, 11-3 in the bottom of the seventh inning. York has tripped up Somerset, 5-2. Bridgeport over Southern Maryland, 3-1. So the Barnstormers lose the ground they gained last night and will close out Sunday trailing Sugarland by 3 and York by 4 in the Freedom Division. The good news is the Barnstormers are ahead in both of those season series, but Lancaster can't crack that 500 mark. They have gotten back to it 3 times now and have lost the following game. On the Major League scoreboard, Washington leading the St. Louis Cardinals this afternoon 10-2. That is in the bottom half of the eighth inning. Milwaukee ahead of Cincy 5-2 through 7. The Chicago Cubs with a substantial lead, 7-1. That's in the bottom of the seventh at home against the Phils. San Francisco 2-0 over Colorado in the top of the second. San Diego and Arizona tied at 1. That's in the bottom of the second inning. Miami at Atlanta late afternoon. The nationally televised game tonight, the LA Dodgers at the New York Mets. Over in the American League, everything's gotten started. Boston and Toronto are in the 10th inning, deadlocked at 3. The Baltimore Orioles have defeated the Cleveland Indians this afternoon 6-4. The Yankees with a 2-1 lead over Tampa Bay. Eovaldi, their hottest pitcher, goes to 6-2. Chicago 4 and the Kansas City Royals 2. That's in the top half of the 8th out at KC. Texas ahead of Pittsburgh 4-2 in the 6th. The LA Angels scored in the first inning. That holds up 1-0 over Houston in the bottom of the fourth. Detroit leads Oakland 1-0 in the bottom of the second inning. And also in the bottom of the second, Minnesota and Seattle are tied at 1. Tomorrow it's Austin Bibbins-Dirks on the hill for the Barnstormers. He comes in with a record of 2 wins, 3 losses. Aaron Thompson with the start for Sugarland. He's a lefty who will come in with a record of 1-0. Game time tomorrow once again at 2:00 in the afternoon. And a reminder from those of us with the Lancaster Barnstormers, be safe this holiday weekend. Enjoy the opportunity for a picnic and whatever else may be in the plans. But at the same time, do take a moment and remember and pay respect to our fallen men and women in the military who have died in the service of this country to give us the opportunity to have the Memorial Day holiday weekend barbecues picnics, and Barnstormers baseball. Again, coming up at 2 o'clock tomorrow. If you can't be with us in person, make sure you're tuned in here along the Barnstormers YouTube channel. We'll be on the air with the Gockenauer Home Appliances Dugout Report at 1:45. Until then, for all the cast and crew here at Clipper Magazine Stadium, I'm Dave Collins. Have a great, safe, happy holiday weekend, everybody. And we will see you at the ballpark.